change them, alter every life. Every day is a danger. That's just life.
You've been relieved of your investigative function.
Yes, I know that, sir. I just thought this might be helpful.
I'm afraid not. Miss Scully, I think you underestimate the duties and responsibilities of my position as assistant director.
Did you ask her about the tape?
She says she doesn't have it.
Is that what she says?
Yes, that's what she says.
Drop your weapon! Put it down, Scully!
No way.
I said put it down!
I said no!
Drop your weapon! I said back off! Put it down!
What the hell is this? What are you pulling here?
Give me that tape.
Oh, this tape stares at me.
Give her the tape.
What you say is true. The information on this tape is valuable enough to kill for. And it's the only leverage we've got to bring these men to justice.
Doesn't matter where I got those. The only thing that matters is that that man is called to answer. Now I want his name.
I don't know his name.
You know how to get it.
These men don't have names.
Well, then you tell me how to find him.
Agent Mulder, there was a time when I might have been able to tell you how to contact him, but that time has passed.
What is this?
This is where you pucker up and kiss my ass.
Now listen, you...
Now you listen to me, you son of a bitch. This man's name is Albert Hostein. You should remember that. Because if Agents Mulder and Scully come down with so much as a case of the flu, Albert is prepared to recite chapter and verse, file for file, everything on your precious tape.
It's a nice try, Skinner.
That information is available with a simple phone call. Welcome to the wonderful world of high technology.
You're bluffing.
Am I?
Unacceptable.
When I was 18, I went to Vietnam. I wasn't drafted, Mulder. I enlisted in the Marine Corps the day of my 18th birthday. I did it on a blind faith. I did it because I believed that it was the right thing to do. I don't know, maybe I still do.
Who is she? What's gonna come out?
I told you once what happened to me in Vietnam. I was caught in an ambush.
Yeah, you were the sole survivor. You also described what sounded like a near-death experience.
I saw lots of things over there. I didn't give much credence to any of them.
Why not?
I got through that experience like most 18-year-olds. By numbing myself with whatever was around. I was no choir boy. I inhaled.